ఏపీ సీఎం జగన్ మోహన్ రెడ్డి గుడ్ న్యూస్ చెప్పారు. జనవరి 1 2002 నుంచి పెన్షన్ 2500 రూపాయలు పెంచినట్లుగా ప్రభుత్వం నిర్ణయం తీసుకుంది. కొత్త ఏడాదిలో అపాతాతలకు జగన్ సర్కార్ కానుక అందించనుంది. వైఎస్ జగన్ సర్కార్ కలెక్టర్ అధికారులతో వీడియో కాన్ఫరెన్స్ సందర్భంగా వెల్లడించారు.
Moving on to the first topic, that is COVID-19. Dinik sambandhinchi, I need not mention that good job. In fact, 32 rounds of house-to-house survey jarigindi. Ee roju, as we speak, we are conducting 32nd round of house-to-house survey. So, dinik sambandhinchi, mee andariki kuda telisina vishayame, there is a new variant we speak about that is being recently spoken about, different names people are giving it, but whatever that is, Omicron or Omicron, whatever that is a new variant that is seeing the light of the day, which requires little bit of caution because of its ability to percolate at a faster pace than any other variant. So ఈ బ్యాక్గ్రౌండ్లో మళ్ళీ కొంచెం గార్డెడ్గా ఉండాల్సిన అవసరము, గార్డెడ్గా ఉండాల్సిన పరిస్థితి కొంచెం ఇస్ రిక్వైర్డ్. జాగ్రత్తలు తీసుకోవాలని అందరూ అన్ని జాగ్రత్తలు కూడా దయచేసి తీసుకోవాల్సిందిగా ఆల్ ది కలెక్టర్స్ ఆర్ రిక్వెస్టెడ్. ఆర్ ట్రాకింగ్ అండ్ ట్రేసింగ్ ఆఫ్ దీస్ పీపుల్, స్పెషలీ ఫారెన్ రిటర్నీస్, దట్ ఈస్ వెరీ వెరీ ఇంపార్టెంట్. ప్లీజ్ మేక్ షూర్ దట్ ఎవ్రీ ఫారెన్ రిటర్నీ is monitored. They've got to, you should leave no stone unturned in ensuring that these people are properly monitored. You would have to know where they are, you would have to know how they are doing. You just cannot afford to just let them loose, which could actually result into another pandemic. So please make sure that every foreign returnee is closely monitored. 15.60 lakh houses construction anedi jarugutha undi. The 15.60 lakh houses would have been initiated in the first phase for pedalandarki illu navaratnalu karyakramamlo. Dintlo the number of houses that have been grounded are 10.72 lakh houses. Close to 70%. So it's very important that the remaining houses are grounded at the earliest. So it's very important that these houses that are yet to be started, yet to be grounded, are revisited by the collector and identify the reasons as to why they have not been grounded as yet. And apply your mind and energy and focus into this particular area and make sure that every house that is being sanctioned is grounded. So this is one very, very important aspect. All grounding activities, the target set forth would be 31st January 2022. So 31st January kalla, all the houses need to be grounded, all the sanctioned houses. The government is waiving off almost 10,000 crores of rupees. This is a huge amount. In fact, out of close to 15,000 crores of rupees, what actually are due, we are waiving off 10,000 crores of that money and facilitating this OTS. This would give them freehold title, meaning they would have the right, they would have the title to sell the property if they want the very next day, or gift it to somebody the very next day, or even pledge this property in a bank for any of their individual purposes the very next day. Scheme is a waiver of registration fee. In fact, the house and the property put together in many cases, average is ranging from 5 lakhs to 10 lakhs. So it's very important that there is proper awareness is created and properly it is spoken about. In fact, the people who are critical about this scheme might comment so many things. The worst part is, why didn't the previous governments not do it? Why didn't the previous governments not even waive, forget about the waiver of the amount of loan outstanding, but they never even bothered to waive the interest part. Forget about the outstanding loan part. These people who have not done even that, even it be these people who have not even done to that extent, are now commenting because they are anti-poor. They don't want this kind of rights over this property bestowed to the people, to the poor. That is the problem with these people. So this would have to be properly explained to every individual, and these people should be told about the benefits of the scheme. So far, the scheme has already started receiving good response. Jagannanna Smart Townships. This is also one aspect which has been developed for the welfare, for the good of the middle class, middle income group category, where we are actually developing these lands, wanting to give them litigation-free titles, wanting to develop this land with all the infrastructure facilities made available. So all the infrastructure facilities made available, litigation-free title also made available, the government stands guarantee, and the rate being at the least possible. So this would ensure that the middle income group category benefit hugely because of this scheme. Spandana grievances. And this is one aspect where until and unless collectors own it up, this program will not be a success. So basically, you know, somebody comes to us for some help. What is the mechanism that is in store? This is called Spandana. We've christened it as Spandana. We want to make sure that this mechanism, what is in place, really serves the purpose. And for it to happen, until and unless the collectors own it up, until and unless you monitor the quality of redressal, I once again repeat this word, until and unless you monitor the quality of redressal, we will never be justifying ourselves. We will never be doing justice to our jobs. The reason why I'm saying this is there have been quite a few cases, quite a percentage, where we have cleared the case, yet there is a reapplication coming in. Fair enough. Here there are two aspects. One aspect is there should be quality redressal at the very first instance when you dispose of the case. That's the first thing that needs to be improved. The second thing that needs to be improved is when somebody reapplies, that means you have rejected the case previously, now it has come back for redressal once again as a reapplication. In those particular cases, how are you dealing with that? These are the two very important things that are very, very important for this program to be actually serving the purpose. So it's very important that the collectors, the joint collectors, RBK, these people actually own it up. Because this is something which has never been done before. This is something what we are attempting now. And first time you also have a situation where even if that paddy is not of the best of the quality, broken, discolored, even this category of paddy also, tadichina, rangumarina, itwanti paddy in kuda, this kind of paddy also is being procured. Ultimately, these kind of initiatives that we are taking is to ensure that the confidence in the farming community, the farmers' confidence in the government, takes a huge leap forward. The quality of paddy, if it is to that required quality, if it is there to that required quality, every farmer should get the MSP, not 1 rupee less. The NREGS part, we're talking about Grama Sachwalayas, Raitu Bharosa Kendras, health clinics, and digital libraries. In these aspects, it's very important that by Ugadi, Raitu Bharosa Kendras and Grama Sachwalayas and health clinics, all these three are completed. The digital libraries, of course, have just started, but they should also be expedited. These four in the village, along with Nadu Nedu schools, English medium schools, also present in the village, will totally change the outlook of the village. The Grama Sachwalayam, the RBKs for farmers, the health clinics with 24/7 service available, with the digital libraries, with as a point of presence, uninterrupted bandwidth available, and the CBSE English medium schools at the village level. These will totally change the way the village is actually visualized as. So please focus on these areas. These are the dates that we have set aside for the month of December and in January, so as to organize for these programs. 21st December, we will be launching Jagadanna Sampurna Gruhahak program. 28th December, we would be launching release of benefits to the new beneficiaries for all the programs implemented post-April and applied thereafter. Every time the program takes off, we say, oka nela extra time istamu, arhata unde edana porapatana miss out aipoyininte, please reapply. We will re-verify and ensure that you don't miss out. Ani manam cheppe matalaku, every year, December month and June month, these are the 2 months that we have segregated to ensure that the entire backlog, whatever has been committed for in those 6 months, is attended to. So Dan Prakaram, the release of benefits to the new beneficiaries for all the programs implemented post-April and applied thereafter, that's going to be implemented on 28th December. On 1st of January, this is going to be a very big program. Pensions, launching of enhanced pension Kanuka to 2,500 rupees. As promised, as committed, the pension amount would be enhanced to 2,500. It's going to be on 1st January, it's a big program. Then on 9th January,
EBC Nestham. We are launching this program, which will talk about 45 to 60 years of age in between, beneficiaries belonging to EBCs, where we would handhold them for 3 years, the same beneficiary for 3 years, giving them 45,000 rupees so as to empower those women there in that category. 15,000 every year, 3 years, 45,000. To the same beneficiary year after year, so that they are actually empowered. So that would be the program concerning EBCs, launched as EBC Nestham on 9th January. And Raitu Bharosa third installment, this program would also be in the month of January. The dates we would finalize going forward. These are the five programs that we would be talking about during the month of December going forward and during the month of January. So please make sure that whatever arrangements that need to be done, especially concerning social audit, display of lists at Sachivalayams, these kind of minute details are attended to, so that nobody is missed out, and the benefit is given to every person who is eligible, and every ineligible person does not get it. So please make sure that these things are also attended to.